Let's take a look at the reactions that alkenes and alkynes undergo. So, the first four are all considered addition reactions: hydrogenation, hydration, halogenation, and hydrohalogenation. Yes, I know those all sound very similar. We're also going to look at polymerization and the Diels-Alder reaction. So hydrogenation, as the name implies, is a reaction with hydrogen gas. So what you're doing is hydrogen is adding to each carbon, you're killing the double bond, and you're getting your alkane back. Your catalyst could be palladium, platinum, nickel, heat, pressure, okay? So when you're doing hydrogenation, essentially all you're doing is getting rid of the double bond, taking your alkene and converting it back into an alkane. So for instance, what would the product of each one of these reactions be? Well, one hydrogen goes here, one hydrogen goes here, right? And the double bond goes away. In this example, one hydrogen goes here, one hydrogen goes here, and the double bond goes away. So we're just left with our alkane in both scenarios. So we have reduced the double bond down to a single bond. We've taken the alkene and turned it into an alkane. And that is hydrogenation. It sounds like hydrogen, just remember that. Halogenation is adding a halogen. It's going to work the same way as hydrogenation, except now instead of adding a hydrogen to each carbon, you're going to add halogen. So this X could be Br, it could be two Brs, two Cls, whatever. X is just the halogen. So one halogen goes on this carbon, one halogen goes on this carbon. And so now we've reduced that double bond again, but now we need to name it appropriately, right? So this would be, for instance, 1,2-dibromo or whatever. So if we're doing this example, in the number one, chlorine gas is our halogen. So one chlorine is going to go here, one chlorine is going to go here. It doesn't matter which side we begin numbering from because it's going to be 2,3 either way. In this example, bromine is the halogen, so one bromine will go here, one bromine will go here, right? So we can begin numbering 1,2, or we can go 1,2. Again, it won't matter. And so halogenation works very similarly to hydrogenation. You're just adding one of each atom to the double bond and reducing that double bond down to a single bond. In hydration, you're adding water. And so we call this an asymmetric addition because, like in the previous examples, the two atoms were the same, right? They were symmetric. But here, H and OH are different. So 1H goes here and OH goes here, right? So you're going to have possibilities. You could have the OH on this carbon or you could have the OH on this carbon. Sometimes it won't make a difference if you've got a very tiny chain, but other times it will make a difference. So let's look at an example. We've got propene here. We've got two possibilities. We could get H goes here, OH goes here, right? That's what gives us this one. We could get H goes here, OH goes here. That's what gives us this one. So these two are not the same thing, right? This one has an OH on carbon 2. This one has an OH on carbon 1. So there is one answer that is favored over the other. And how we decide that is based on Markovnikov's rule. So when an acid like HCl, HBr, or when we add water added to a double bond, just think about hydrogen wants to go be with its friends, right? The hydrogen goes to the carbon that had more hydrogens initially. If both carbons in the double bond had the same number of hydrogens, then Markovnikov's rule won't apply. But look at our previous example. This carbon had two hydrogens initially, and this carbon only had one. So you can think of Markovnikov's rule as hydrogen wanting to be with its friends. Hydrogen's gonna go be with its friends. This carbon had two hydrogens, this carbon only had one. So that's why this hydrogen goes here, this OH goes here, and that's why two propanols are major product, whereas one propanol is our minor product. So just follow Markovnikov's rule. If both carbons in the double bond have the same number of hydrogens, then Markovnikov's rule is not an issue. All right, so here's another example following Markovnikov's rule. Again, just look at the number of hydrogens. This carbon has two hydrogens on it. This carbon only has one. So hydrogen's gonna add to the carbon that has more hydrogens initially, and the OH will go on the other one. All right, so this is our major product. Here's another example in following Markovnikov's rule. Right, this carbon had one hydrogen, this carbon had zero hydrogens. Now hydrohalogenation is gonna work just like hydration does. It's called asymmetric addition. It's going to follow Markovnikov's rule as well. You've got H that's gonna go on one carbon, and then the halogen, could be Cl, could be Br, right? The halogen's gonna go on the other carbon. We're gonna follow Markovnikov's rule again. The hydrogen's gonna go on the carbon that had more hydrogens initially. So here's an example following Markovnikov's rule with HCl addition. This carbon had two hydrogens initially. This carbon only had one, so that means hydrogen's gonna go here, chlorine's gonna go here, giving this our major product. And then polymerization is when you add a molecule to itself. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time in these videos going over polymerization. I think you can read about it on your own. I'm trying not to make these videos too long, so that they're not big, giant, mega files. Just read about polymers on your in your notes online and in the textbook. They're not very difficult. The last one we want to talk about in alkenes is Diels-Alder. And when you take full semester organic chemistry, you actually get to this in organic too. But this is a big part of organic chemistry, so I at least want to introduce you to it now. We won't get into it at the level of detail that you'll see when you take organic, if you take the full semester, but I at least want to introduce you to it. All right, so the Diels-Alder reaction, you must have a diene, so a molecule of two double bonds, and you must have an alkene. So this is the simplest diene you can have. This is the simplest alkene you can have. Of course, there could be things coming off, right? But this is the simplest diene, and that's the simplest alkene. And so, if you label your carbons, just label it A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay? This is the electron pushing diagram showing how this product forms. So a bond is going to form between F and A. This double bond between A and B is going to get pushed up to be between B and C. And then a bond is going to form between D and E. So that's going to give us a cycloalkene. So that's why I say if you just number them A, B, C, D, E, F, a new bond forms between D and E, and a new bond forms between A and F, and then that double bond that was originally between A and B is now between B and C. So this is the skeleton of the product that you form. And then if there were, say, a chlorine sticking up here, there'd still be a chlorine sticking up over here. Okay, so but if you know the skeleton of your product, any substituents that are on your diene and your alkene will transfer along with it. So here's what I just said. If carbon E had a chlorine, then that chlorine would go along with it. So here's another one. This is also involving carbon E. Of course, it's not always going to involve carbon E, but I just happened to choose two examples. So we've got a 1, 2, 3 carbon chain. It transferred along with it. All right, now with alkynes, the only two reactions we're gonna deal with alkynes are hydrogenation and halogenation, anhydrogenation and halogenation in alkynes work just like they did in alkenes. All right, so hydrogenation, the only difference is now we need a coefficient of 2 because we've got a triple bond that we need to reduce. So hydrogen, 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 hydrogen reduces it down to an alkane. The first hydrogen adds and reduces it to an alkene. The second hydrogen adds and reduces it to an alkane. And then it'll work the exact same way with halogenation. So 2 chlorines go on this carbon, 2 chlorines go on this carbon. And so we've got chloro, 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 chloro. And that's an overview of nomenclature and reactions of alkenes and alkynes.